Thank you, Admiral Greener, for that kind introduction. I don't think my mother could have given me a better one. It's fabulous. And thank you for nominating me tonight. I'd also like to thank the Navy Memorial Foundation for the honor of being included in this program alongside two iconic American heroes and so many great Americans in this room tonight. You know, the Navy became my favorite service very early in life. You know, I can remember every Sunday night making sure that I watched Prudential's Victory at Sea telecast. And of course, there was Joe Bellino and Roger Staubach. But frankly, in the spring of 1968, my plans didn't include military service. I was accepted and on my way to graduate school. That is, until I received my draft notice, 1 week after I graduated. 1968, you remember the year of the Tet Offensive in Vietnam and virtually no graduate deferments and no lottery. So I was going. But frankly, you know, it was a wonderful, wonderful opportunity for me. I took my draft physical and I enlisted in the Navy, applied to OCS. But what I forgot was that they were going to send me to Great Lakes to boot camp before I heard back from OCS. And of course, there I'll start with what the Navy has given me that has lasted through my career. The first lesson, boot camp. That lesson was humility and the ability to follow orders and the ability to be part of a team. That said, the 3 years I spent in the Navy and active duty were truly formative. The training I received at OCS and the Naval Supply School were really world class, and they fully prepared me at age 23 to head a division of 150 men, some of which were old enough to be my father. That accelerated my transition from boyhood to manhood. Not only did it impose serious responsibility and accountability at a young age, but it confronted me with an early challenge of becoming a leader. Most importantly, it rooted in me the core values that I learned there, and they've translated into the values of my own firm now, one of integrity, professionalism, and trust. I'm proud to be a Navy veteran, and I'm especially proud to have served on the USS Wasp, a ship with a wonderful history, including service as a Gemini recovery ship for many of Senator Glenn's fellow astronauts. I attended her decommissioning ceremony in 1972. There were about 500 men pierside, all brothers in a grand reunion of ship's company. And yes, there were even some brown shoes there, but not a dry eye to be found. Hey. I have only one regret, and that is after kicking the behind of our peer mate in operational readiness, it was the USS Intrepid that would become a National Sea, Air, and Space Museum. There's only one consolation, and Admiral Green had mentioned it. Her name lives on an LHD-1, an amphibious assault ship. The Navy has contributed mightily to me personally, and so I intend to give back through worthy veterans programs like those led at my alma mater at Syracuse University. Syracuse has a proud history of veterans advocacy. They admitted 17,000 veterans back from World War II, more by far than any other university. And they've operated the Army's controllership training program for decades and now lead a reentry program called Entrepreneurship Boot Camp for Veterans with Disabilities. Now that program has moved on to 10 affiliated universities. In 2014, during the installation ceremony and his inaugural address, Chancellor Kent Severud stated that serving veterans would be one of the four major strategic goals of Syracuse University. And under his mandate, SU has recently established the Institute for Veterans and Military Families, headed by Vice Chancellor Mike Haney. The IVMF offers a wide range of support to veterans and families, and I'm privileged to be co-chairman. Chancellor Severud is with us tonight. Chancellor, could you please rise and be recognized? And also Vice Chairman Haney, please rise. Thank you for what you're doing for our veterans. So in conclusion, I've tried as we all should, to remain an active advocate for our veterans. Thanks again to the U.S. Navy Memorial Foundation, my family and wife of 40 years, Gail, who are here tonight, both, all of you who have served and supported the service and veterans, thank you. God bless our veterans, and go Navy.
You did a great job.
5 minutes and 49 seconds.